Connective tissue diseases are a group of autoimmune disorders that affect the connective tissues within the body. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. Our body is held together at a cellular level by tissues that connect structures to one another. Whenever a disease is present that negatively affects these connective tissues, it can be referred to as a connective tissue disease. Some examples include scleroderma, rheumatoid arthritis, Sjögren syndrome, polymyositis, and systemic lupus erythematosus. Scleroderma is a chronic autoimmune disease that causes the skin and tissues of the body to become thick and hardened. Rheumatoid arthritis is a chronic inflammatory disorder that causes painful swelling in your joints. It occurs when your body's immune system inadvertently attacks its own tissues. Sjögren syndrome is a systemic autoimmune disorder characterized by dry eyes and a dry mouth. Polymyositis is an inflammatory disease characterized by severe muscle weakness. And lupus is an autoimmune disease characterized by inflammation and tissue damage that again occurs when your body's immune system attacks its own tissues. Again, there are several other conditions that can be classified as a connective tissue disease. These are just a few of the most common examples that I wanted to bring to your attention. With that said, you should also note that interstitial lung disease, or ILD, is a term that describes any respiratory disorder that causes scarring of the tissues within the lungs. It's a complication that is common in patients with connective tissue diseases. The lung damage that occurs from interstitial lung disease is often irreversible and unfortunately gets worse over time. Again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. We'll be breaking it down into much more detail in a separate video. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for educational and informational purposes only. And if you want to dive deeper and learn more about this topic, you can go to respiratorytherapyzone.com, where we have a ton of free study guides, practice questions, and other helpful resources. I'll drop links to everything you need right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.